guys, and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. My name's Claire, and this video is going to be my August empties video. I have my trusty crate here of all the items that I used up in the month of August. There's a little bit of skincare, a little bit of body care, and a little bit of wax and some makeup in here as well. So a big mixture of everything this time around, so I'm just gonna go through things as they come out of my box. The first item is this. This is the Carex Fun Edition Drumstick Squashies Shower and Bath Gel. This was nice. I used this as a bubble bath. It kind of smelled really good, but like a lot of these things that promise that they're gonna smell amazing, it didn't really smell of anything once it was in the bath. So I probably wouldn't get it again for that reason, just because I would want something that smells maybe a bit stronger, that I can relax in, that smells good. This just wasn't doing that for me, so I won't get this again. I have here the Your Good Skin Refreshing Face Wash. I've been through multiples of these and I have multiple backups in my drawer. I really enjoy this face wash. It kind of cleanses your skin and gets rid of all the dirt without making your skin feel really dry, so I do enjoy this. I use this morning, sometimes in the evening, depending on what I have in my collection at that time. But yes, as I said, I have more in my drawer. So this is something that I finished up pretty early in the month of August and probably wasn't a surprise to you. This is the Soap and Glory One Dishner Intensive Conditioning Hair Mask, and that is all cleaned out of there. It's still a little bit damp from when I had it in the bath, but yes, this was okay. I didn't notice that it did anything. I probably wouldn't buy it again because Soap and Glory is expensive. I did get this in one of their Christmas collection tin things, and it was on sale in January, and it was a ridiculous sale price. So, I mean, if I saw that tin again, and it was a ridiculous sale price again, something like £100 worth of items for like £24 or something, it was really stupid, then I would probably get it again, but I wouldn't go out and buy this as a hair mask that I must have again, if that makes sense. Like, it smelled nice, but it didn't really do anything in terms of like intensive conditioning. So yeah, I would expect more from something that identifies as intensive conditioning for nourished, healthy, and revived hair. That's that one. This I did enjoy. This is the Revolution Skincare Pineapple Tonic. This is a brightening tonic with papaya extract. I really enjoyed this. It was kind of expensive for a toner, but I would probably get it again, to be honest. I liked that it had like a slight brightening aspect to it, so it made my skin feel more youthful, I guess. I was using this with vitamin C as well, so it could have been the combination of the two. I really rate Revolution Skincare. There are some things that don't work for me and some things that do, but that's like any skincare line and it's affordable. So I would definitely recommend. The reflection is throwing my camera out. It's like, where do I focus? It's really funny. If you're looking for a good toner or a brightening toner and you haven't tried Revolution Skincare yet, then I would definitely recommend it. I believe this particular one is on sale right now, so check it out. I would get that one again, but I have so many toners to go through right now that I'm not even going to buy it at the sale price because I just don't need to be bringing anything more into my collection at this point. But yeah, I have this. This is the Maybelline Baby Skin Instant Pore Eraser. This was in a project pan. This is all done now. I finished using it today and I kind of had to really work the container to get enough out to do what I needed it for today. So I'm not even going to try and force it anymore because it's kind of old and I have other primers. This is proper old school good stuff. I don't even know if they sell this anymore, but if they do, then I would consider picking it up again. But I would want to try other primers first, I think. I've had this a few times now and it's a good quality product, but there are other things that do the same pore blurring situation. When this first came out, it was like pretty much the only dupe for the Benefit Professional at that time, and now there's so many different ones that you don't necessarily need to go back to this one. But if you've not tried this one and you were thinking about trying this one, I would say yes, go for it, try it, because it's really good. I have the Avon Footworks Beautiful Cooling Spray. This is just like a foot spray. There's a teeny bit left in here, I don't know if you can hear, but I can't get it out. Even if I try like angling the sprayer, I can't get it out, and I'm not gonna like take the thing off and then decant it into my hand and use it that way. So I'm just gonna call it done. I wouldn't repurchase this, not because I don't get Avon anymore, not because I don't support Avon anymore, not because the product was bad, but because of the scent. It wasn't a bad scent, it was okay, it was pineapple, it was nice. But then it was the kind of scent that like permeated the air, even if you sprayed it just once and a teeny bit. It would just kind of like get everywhere, like in your nose, at the back of your throat, and then you'd be tasting it and you'd be like basically choking on, even if you just sprayed it like once. And it's, if you spray it like two or three times, then that just amplifies it. So I wouldn't get it again for that. Like, I didn't like the feeling of like having the scent become one with my body. It was very claustrophobic-y and not a pleasant experience. I have this. This is the Haz Isopropyl Rubbing Alcohol 70% First Aid Antiseptic. I use this for repressing or for cleansing my makeup. Not like cleansing, but you know, like sanitizing my makeup. I think I will get a 90% next time, but the Haz is, I mean, it's okay. I got it on Amazon. Amazon still, even now, is short on rubbing alcohol because of coronavirus and stuff. So just bear that in mind if you're gonna try and get a hold of this. I couldn't even see this on Amazon when I looked. So it was okay. It took a while to dry. That's why I wanna try the 90. And for what I'm going to be using it for, the 90 is kind of okay. 99 is pushing it because it would just dry too quickly to do anything. But I think 90 would be okay. But the 70 was nice. Just when I was repressing something, it would take like 24 hours to dry as opposed to the 90, which would dry in maybe 30% less of the time. So I had this. This is the John Frieda Frizzies Forever Smooth Anti-Frizz Primer. I got this in a box ages ago. I think maybe it was a Look Fantastic box, or it wasn't Cohorted. It was maybe Look Fantastic or another one that's a similar price to the Look Fantastic. I had so many boxes ages, like 2016, 2017, I had basically all of the boxes coming to my door, and this was in one of them. And I finally finished it up and it didn't really do anything. Honestly, it didn't anti-frizz my hair at all. I just used it for the sake of using it. I didn't notice that it conditioned my hair. I didn't notice that it did anything from like reducing my frizz or making it feel less dry. It was just something that I used for the sake of using. So I would not buy this with my own money. If I got it in a box again, would I use it again? Probably not. I might give it to my brother. My brother's hair's short right now, but when he likes to grow it out, he does use the Frizzies products. So I would consider doing that probably rather than trying to use this again. So this was another one that was finished off really early and probably not a surprise if you watch my Project Pans. This is the Soap and Glory, the Scrub of Your Life body scrub. This was in my Rocky Horror Project Pan and it had like one use left when the project finished. And I had that one use and this is now gone. Packet looks still a bit blown out, but it's only because it's got air in it. Like, I squeezed literally everything out. This was nice. I do enjoy the Soap and Glory scrubs, but as I said previously with the hair thing, the Soap and Glory is really expensive. So if I was to get it again, then I would get it in like one of their tins and maybe on sale. But the only thing that I would consider from their line getting at full price would be the Heal Genius, because that foot cream is the best foot cream I've ever tried. Anything else, I would maybe think twice. Their body butters are like £10. I think the scrub is like £8, and I don't really need to spend £8 on a body scrub. So I have some sachets here. Feel Unique do a thing where you can, it's called Pick a Mix, and basically you can order 5 different sample size products to try out for free, and you just pay for the postage and then they credit the postage back to your account that you can use as a voucher later on. But I got these because I wanted to try some Sol de Janeiro products because I've not tried any of their products before. This shampoo and conditioner, I'm not gonna buy, but if I was to have the option to get it in the Pick and Mix again, I would get it in the Pick and Mix again. Not because it did anything wow to my hair, like it was just an okay shampoo and conditioner. If anything, the conditioner didn't really condition much of my hair, and the shampoo cleansed it, but it struggled to foam up. It was a really interesting experience, but it smelled amazing. Oh my god, I've never smelled anything like it. And if they could just like put this, the scent, in like a perfume or something. And I know they have perfumes, but their perfumes don't smell like this smells. This just smelled on another level. It was just amazing. Amazing. But all of their products smell amazing. So I have another sachet that I got in my Feel Unique Pick and Mix. This is the Shu Uemura Art of Hair Urban Moisture Moringo Mask. This smelled amazing. It still smells amazing, even though the sachet is empty. But did it do enough for my hair? Like, the full size of this, to buy this, I think it's like £42. And I don't think that it did £42 worth of conditioning to my hair. I'm still looking for a mask that like really, really, really conditions my hair. And this just wasn't it. And I probably probably wouldn't buy it for £42. I might get it if it was like heavily discounted for like 20, then I'd consider it, but not for the price that they're currently charging for it. I have some declutter things here. I have some brushes. I have this. This was from the Urban Decay Vice Palette. It's just the double-ended thing. I've never used this brush. I don't even know why I still have this brush. I have this LNY blending brush. It's just like a crease blending brush. I bought this off of eBay with another LNY brush that I'm actually keeping. This one just seems to have frayed at the edges with age and just seems a bit limp and lifeless now, so I'm not gonna keep that anymore. This one is unbranded, but as you can see, all the outside veneer has like chipped off where I've been washing it. But to be fair, I've had this brush for probably about 10 years at this point, so I'm not complaining about that. And the edges are kind of frayed a little bit as well, so I'm just gonna toss this one. And this is another one that's done that weird, like the veneers come off the actual brush kind of thing, and so I'm gonna toss this as well. This was another one that lasted me a while. This one didn't last me as long. I think this one was maybe 5 years or so this one lasted me. The wooden handle ones were just amazing. I would get these again if I could find them, but you can't even find them anymore, unfortunately. But yeah, getting rid of those. I also have some makeup here. So I decided it was going to be a good idea to basically lip swatch my entire, not my entire collection, my entire fall and winter collection of lipsticks. So I have 6 lipsticks here that I was going to declutter because they just don't work for me anymore. So I have the Lacquer & Co. Cloud Lips lipstick. This is like a mauvey matte lipstick. I just don't like this formula on my lips. I don't know, it feels weird. It's very reminiscent of the NYX Soft Matte Lip Creams, but a worse formula. I don't know if that makes sense. I couldn't get on with the formula, so I'm not even gonna try and use that one up. This one is another one that I didn't get on with the formula just because it never dried down. This is the Maybelline Vivid Matte Liquid. This is in the shade number 5 Nude Flush, and it is a very similar color to the one that I just swatched, but as I said, it never dries down, and it just, I don't know, the formula just felt weird on my lips, just kind of like cakey on my lips. I have this one. This is the Sleek Matte Me Ultra Smooth Matte Lip Cream in Shabby Chic. I had 2 of these because I bought one and then I got another one in a subscription box, and I'm tossing this one because this one just smells straight up bad. Like, it's supposed to smell like vanilla and the other one still smells like vanilla. This one just smells like paint thinner. Still smells like paint thinner. So I'm not going to trust that on my lips, so that one can go in the bin, and that is what that one looks like. I have this I Heart Revolution liquid lipstick in the shade Meteor. This I would love to love, but it's so patchy on the lips that I can't do it, and even swatching it here, it's really patchy, and every time you go over it to make it not patchy, it just makes it more patchy, and I'm just not working with it. I'm not. I don't know if you can see how patchy that is from my swatching, but yeah, I'm just not gonna deal with it. And to be honest, the formula is that bad that I don't even feel like anyone would want this, so I'm just gonna toss that even though it's pretty new. I have the Model Co. lipstick in the shade Smitten. This is a beautiful shade, but it doesn't look right on me. I very, very, very rarely reach for a red, and when I do, this kind of red just doesn't suit me, so I'm just going to pass this on. This is too old to pass to anyone, so that's gonna go in the bin. And this one is also really old. This is the Avon Color Trend lipstick in Lucky Kiss. This has been in multiple project pans, and I never reach for it, and it's because I don't get on with the shade. And again, it's that kind of red that's, I guess, pink based rather than blue based, so it doesn't really suit me. And even though I sometimes wear red, it's just not the kind of red that I ever reach for or think that looks good on me, so I'm going to get rid of that as well. I have another brush here that I completely forgot about. Oh, this is another one that's doing that weird thing with the red at the end here. I have some more makeup here. I had a call with Erin the other day, and I basically offered her some things, and these were the things that she decided she didn't want from my declutter box that I was going to pass to her. And this is the Iconic London Liquid Illuminator in the shade Shine. I really enjoyed this, but I don't like this kind of product. Like, I enjoyed the effect it has. This is an excellent highlighter. I'm just gonna put it out there. This is beautiful, but I just can't get on with the format of it, and it would take me literally the rest of my life to use it up, so I'm not going to. I just swatched it kind of there on my thumb. I don't know if you can see that if I go that way. So it's beautiful. I'm not going to use this kind of formula. And the same for this. This is the Pixi by Petra Glow Booster, and this is another like liquid highlighter. Creams are easier to use, I think, because you can control a cream better, but liquid they just go on forever. And unless you use them underneath your foundation, which I don't like because it breaks down the foundation. See that? That's just under the red here. I don't know if you can see that. Then you're never going to get through them. And therefore, I'm just going to toss them. I have the Sol Cherusa 62. I'm sorry if I'm not pronouncing that right. I never learned Spanish, so I'm going to butcher everything that I say in Spanish. This is from the Sol de Janeiro. This is the Eau de Parfum. I believe they have one. So they have the body mist, and this is the perfume that they have, which, to be honest, I think I would have preferred the body mist. This was kind of, I mean, it has jasmine and vanilla in it, but I feel like it was very deep scented. It says here, the warmth and rhythms of Brazil, alive and irresistible to capture the heart of summer. This is the scent of Cherusa 62, blended with addictive gourmand notes of salted caramel, pistachio, jasmine petals, and vanilla to touch all of the senses. Feel the scent of summer. So I got the salted caramel and the pistachio, but then it was warm and less bakery, and I think I would have preferred the body mist because the body mist is more bakery than this. Yeah, I wouldn't buy this, basically, is what I'm trying to say. I have another perfume here. I really enjoyed this is the Floral Street Arizona Bloom perfume. This was really nice. I quite enjoy all of the Floral Street perfumes, so I would consider getting this maybe when I finish up some perfumes. Another one that I really enjoyed was the Isumiyaki Nectar, Pure Nectar. This one. I really liked this. This was incredible. I would 100% buy this. Okay, so I have another body wash here. This is the Imperial Leather Love Hearts Shower Cream. This is like the rest of these. I've been through a few of these. So what happened was, I don't know if you saw my inventory, but I basically explained that when I buy body wash, I'll go to the shop when I need body wash and I'll buy like 10 at a time. This is basically the remnants of that haul of like buying all the Imperial Leather things and the Carex thing, the things that smell like candy basically. I've been through a few of them. You've probably seen them on my channel if you watch my empties videos. But like the rest of them, this smelt nice if you like squeeze it up your nose, but it doesn't smell of anything when you wash yourself with it. And the scent doesn't last on the skin, so I wouldn't get this again for that reason. But if you're not a big fan of scents, then you probably will enjoy that. It cleaned my body fine, it didn't dry me out, it was nice. Something really exciting, I finished up a Maybelline color tattoo, completely finished this up. This took me maybe 19-20 months to finish. It took a long time, but it's done. I now only have one cream eyeshadow left in my collection, which I'm not gonna work through straight away because I have other eye bases that I wanna use first. But when that cream is gone, then I'll consider buying some more. I'm not gonna buy any more before I finish the ones that I have because creams go dry and they go bad faster. So I have a body cream here. This is the Ritual of Sakura Rich Nourishing Body Cream. This is the second sachet of that body cream that I finished up in my last empties video. As I mentioned in that video, this smell of the rice milk and cherry blossom was really good, but the cream and the hand cream wasn't anything special that you would pay Ritual's prices rather than drugstore prices for a cream. So that's that one. Okay, I have two more makeup beauty kind of items before we go on to the wax. This has a Yankee Candle sticker stuck to it. That's gross. This is the Urban Decay Heavy Metals eyeshadow palette. I did that thing I mentioned in my declutter that I was taking out the shades that I wanted of some of my palettes and then just getting rid of the rest of them because it wasn't worth keeping the whole palette for what here is 8 shades. So I'm throwing out the rest of these. This palette is kind of old and I wouldn't feel comfortable passing this on to anyone because it's really old at this point. Plus half the shades are missing, so I'm just going to toss this. I do enjoy the Urban Decay formula. I'm probably gonna get the Stoned from, is it called Stoned? Or is it Stoned Vibes? For Christmas from Erin. I'm really looking forward to that. And the last item that's kind of beauty related is this. This is the Lip Smackers Lip Balm in the scent Rebel Chocolate. This is a Star Wars lip balm. And it's done that thing where if you pull the lid off, then it goes up a bit. If my camera will focus. But if you try and put any pressure on it, like do it with your lips, then it goes straight back in again. So I'm just calling this done because it was scraping my lips and I have plenty of other lip balms that I'm just not gonna fight with it. And that's everything beauty-wise. I do have some wax empties here that I want to talk about. I have some of these sachets from the Wax Mouse again, because when I did my Etsy order with them, I bought a bunch. I bought basically every single bakery scent that they did in these little parchment papers. So this is Banana Split. 100% would get this again. It was amazing. If you don't like artificial banana, don't buy this. But I love the scent of artificial banana. I have the Wickford & Company Pineapple Crush Scented Wax Melts. This is just an 8-pan clamshell. This was really nice. I have more of this in my collection and I'm kind of savouring it, to be honest. I don't know if you know British candy at all, and you probably can't even buy them anymore, but this scent really reminds me of Chewits. And I don't know if you know what Chewits are. They're basically the poor man's Opal Fruits or Starburst. God, Opal Fruits, that's a throwback. Apparently I'm now living in the 90s again. They're basically the poor man's Starburst. I would say that they're, you get less in a packet, but they're bigger and they're kind of chewier than Starburst. That's what Chewits are. It's the same concept, kind of like taffy, just a chewy candy basically. Anyway, that's a really long way of saying this smelt like those candies, and it kind of took me back to a time where I used to have math tutoring when I was a child, not because I was bad at math, but because I was best at math and my math level was higher than what my parents could teach me, so they kind of passed me to a tutor so that I would increase my math level rather than just like reduce my math level to what my education was providing me. So I had a math tutor, and every single time I went to one of her sessions, she'd just like try and get you to behave. Not when you were teenagers, obviously, but like when you were younger children, she'd try and get you to behave, and she'd basically bribe you with candy, and she always used to give us a packet of Chewits. And when I was burning this, I smelt and remembered that time, and it was so reminiscent for me. So it was just really, really nice. I also have two more from the wax mouse. I have the cappuccino, which was kind of disappointing because it didn't last very long and it didn't throw very well, but the scent that it actually was nice. And caramel fudge didn't really smell of caramel or fudge. It just kind of smelt of generic bakery, which I'm not complaining about, but I would expect a deeper, kind of more intriguing scent for caramel fudge than what came out. And lastly, I have two Yankee Candle products. I have the Yankee Candle Watermelon Slice Votive Candle, and I have the Yankee Candle Vanilla Lime Wax Tart thing. And that's everything for my empties. My box is now empty apart from the things that stay in here because there's not a better home for them. For example, I have tea tins in here because they're empty, but they're in here because I have nowhere to store them. And I'm not throwing them away because the tea company that does these tins, Bud and Blend, they will refill these tins for a discount because it's like a recycling scheme thing. So if you keep your tin, then they'll fill it up with the loose tea and then give you a discount of the price of a full tin. That's why I'm keeping them. But they live in here because I don't want them in my cupboard because they're empty. That's just basically all that's left in here. So yeah, thanks so much for watching this video. Take care and I will see you very soon. Bye! Thank you.